guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'll be showing you how to Texas rig a couple of baits. We have Senko, I'll be pulling out a bandito bug and a trench hog, showing you how to Texas rig it. So first you have your regular 4-aught chain gamakatsu hook. Senko, you can use any size, whatever you're gonna use. So first, I like to flip the hook upside down, get the flat part of the Senko, not the tip, and then there'll be like a little dot in the middle. You'll go right till the end of the hook, like that kind of. So see how it's like that? Go up. Alright. Then you're gonna pull like this. So now you have it like this. You're gonna push this up. Push that up to here. The Senko has been used once, so the top's a little messy. And then you'll see this. I'm gonna push this down a little bit. So right now I'm gonna make the hook weedless. So see, the hook's not exposed and I just put it right in there. See? I just put it right in there. And when the fish bites, this will go down and the hook will pop right out when you hook it. Now I'm gonna show you weedle it. I don't know, I forgot the name. What's the opposite of weedless? Okay, I don't know. But all you're going to do is just pop it back out like that. Of course, it's a Senko. And see how the hook is showing a little bit? Pop that out a little more so you guys can see. You guys see that? The hook right here. See how it's popping out a little bit? That's like if your hook set's not too strong and you're not fishing too heavy of cover and you're just fishing. You start off with this. But if you're like fishing, like if you're like throwing your like lily pads or like water, like stuff in the water, like branches and stuff, you want your hook weedless. So that's, again, back inside, you can't see the hook from the outside. Alright, next on to the other bait. Of course, that bait's used. I'm going to take you guys for a second. So, I will be rigging trench hog. Let's make sure it's not used. Alright, I'm rigging a trench hog, and I'll get out a bandito bug. Alright, and a bandito bug. And comment down below if you want me to make any other videos that you guys want me to make. It could be how to put line on a reel. It could be anything. Just comment down below and I'll see if I can make that video. Alright? So first one's off with the bandito bug, aka creature bait. Same. It's basically the same thing. Start off here. The tip. Not where the claws are. I'll pop that back out. Bring it up. This is the back. Like this, you know. Pull it down. Like that. Now you're gonna push up. You guys cannot even see this. So you see the hook? You go. And you go up. Some baits are like really slimy, like this one. Just broke. Like this one, so it's a little harder to do. Like, if you're doing it, non-weedless. Oh, that's the name for it. If you're doing it non-weed. One second. If you're doing it, non-weedless, it's gonna be, a little slimier. So, I prefer, weedless with bandito bugs or, like, slimy baits that you have. Because it'll just slip off. Okay. This is the worst Texas rigging job because I just split half the bait in half. Alright. And sometimes if, like, say it's not stained for weedless, I like to pop it back out to make it non-weedless. Like that, so. And then I like to push it in a little bit to make it straight. Like that. Push that in. Bang. And I would usually throw these weighted, and you can throw a Senko weightless or weighted. Depends. Yeah, but I definitely prefer these weighted. I don't know anyone that uses a weightless Bandito bug unless they don't have a hook. I would use, I think these are 3/16 of an ounce. I'll put this on the hook. I'll put this on the hook so you can see kind of what size it is. You can't. I'll compare them to Trench Hog. So that's that, and then that's that. That's how. This is Green Pumpkin Cabela's 3/16 ounce weight. They're only $3, and they're same as, they're kind of the same as, tungsten weights, and tungsten weights are a lot of money, as we know. Next, I'll be showing you the Trench Hog. It's the same thing. I don't really know why I'm doing this, but, yeah. Same thing. Go in, pop that out. I'm getting a little faster now. I'm going to try to show you guys one more thing, which I don't know yet, but. Okay, bang. That's weightless. You're going to want to throw these weighted because crawfish don't float. That's a dead one, but fish will probably eat it by the time. So, yeah. Time to think what I'm going to show you guys next. So. Let me put away these baits. I am going to be going to South Carolina in 2 weeks, and that'll be in the intercoastal, so I'll be doing more fishing, and there's going to be golf carts, so stay tuned for some of those kind of videos. Crazy madness videos. We kayak in there, saltwater fishing, all the good stuff. Great. There's a hook somewhere. I don't know where it is. That's great. Okay. I don't know where the hook is. That's great. Oh. Found it. Put it with the 3-aught hooks, not the 4-aught hooks. This is my terminal tackle box. If I haven't showed you guys, I don't think I did. You got your 3/16 ounce weights. You got a Goon Squad hammer hook, 3-aught. You got 3-aught hooks. You got a Ned rig. I dropped one in the water. Some 1/2 ounce weights, 4-aught hooks, swim bait weighted hooks, swim bait weightless hooks. Bluegill / trout hooks. Okay. I'm gonna find something in my bag to show you guys something. I don't know. Some baits that if you guys are like new to fishing, I'll show you some baits that you'll be guaranteed to catch fish on. So first, this is the packaging. Rage Tail Rage Bug. The best. Use Texas rig these. They're coffee scent. They're like $4. They're really good. Throw these weighted. That's the juice. I'd prefer the green pumpkin red flake color. That's a good color. If you're new to fishing, try to stick to soft plastics because lures, they take some effort to do. Like some lures, you can get used to, but some not. I would use a Senko. Some people call them stick baits. Whatever color, I mean, it depends what kind of water you're fishing. If it's like the typical water, like muddy kind of green pumpkin, if it's like crystal clear, if it's crystal clear, I would throw a June bug color. And yeah, here's another pack of those red tails. This is green pumpkin. That's kind of what I'm talking about. I mean, I'll show you a lure that is good for getting into it. I don't know if I have it. Let's see. That's another good bait to use for a beginner. 13 motorboat. Because it's basically a Senko. But then you're kind of getting into the use of a lure. So it's like a 2-in-1 kind of. It's a topwater bait. So that's the 2-in-1. Oh, here. A whopper popper. This is a really good bait for beginners that want to get into lure fishing. The topwater bait, so. The back propels like this, and it'll make like brrrr in the water. And like that noise. And if you want to go to like the next step and you want to go down a little bit, let me find a bait real quick. Yeah. There. The size 3 to 6 feet in the water. That's probably your next bait that you would use. And then, depends how big your fish are in the lake. If they're like, there's like 12 pounders, you're gonna wanna go to something big. So like this is considered a little small. And then this is bigger. Like this is for like 10 pounders. That thing's big. As you can see, that's my forehead. Top water is kind of hard. Depends, like, what kind of fish. So, if your fish aren't eating the whopper popper, I would next go to this. Or Senko's will never fail you. Yeah. Yeah. This is my attack box. Got bloopers right here. Oh, top water ones. There's only one. You got crankbaits, you got deep divers, you have top water baits, you got everything. And yeah, I think broken jerkbait. Oh, and I'll show you. Well, this is like after, once you got used to like using hard baits and like soft plastics. Sorry, guys. Once you got used to using hard baits and soft plastics, I would get to a jig, a spinner bait, or a buzz bait. A buzz bait is top water. Spinner bait is like just spinner bait. I don't know how to explain it. A jig is like a deep diver kind of. Like it dives deep. And chatter bait is makes noise. So this is a jig. Bang. This is a spinner. I didn't think I had one right now, but $1 spinner bait. These are only $1 at Walmart, and they have buzz baits there. They're $1, so go check them out. It's been up with the thing for like over 20 years now. So yeah, this is a chatter bait. See this little metal thing right here? That bangs against there and it makes a noise. My mom almost had a like 7 or 8 pound bass on this same exact one. Chartreuse white chatterbait. But before I would do that, I'll start off with a micro jig or like micro chatterbait. So this is a micro chatterbait. Start with something small kind of. Or if you have big fish, you can go right to that. Like a small jig. Don't fish heavy stuff. You guys can, but I don't like fishing heavy stuff. Like, this is very light. I don't know what size it is, but it's very light. More chatter baits, jig. I like fishing jigs. That's my favorite thing to fish. Like, flipping jigs, football jigs. Favorite baits. I could be in a little tackle box like this. Yeah. And I should show you guys some tools. I'll show you guys the best tools to use to go, like, start fishing. And I'll tell you how much everything was. You don't need this exact stuff. You don't need it. I mean, I would prefer this stuff. You probably need a lot of it if you're getting into fishing. But, all right, I'll start off. Cooter scissors. These cut braid very easy. $5. That's like, you're going to want to get these in like kitchen scissors. Scissors is not the same. If you use kitchen scissors, it's going to fray the line. If you don't know what fray is, look it up on a YouTube video. If you fray the line, that's not good. This is a clean cut every time. Fish grippers. If you're someone that doesn't like to touch fish, grip it by its mouth. You can hold it like this. And if you're going to, if you have a scale, I don't have one on me right now. Instead of harming the fish, hooking it through its gill, you put that on, you put it. Sorry, guys. Someone called me. No, I don't like them. Okay, so as I was explaining, you grip this in the mouth, then you hook your scale right here, and then the fish will be right here, and scale will be up here, and then you can do it without harming them. Pliers. These are the most expensive pliers I got. Someone bought them as me for a gift. You definitely don't need these pliers. You can go to Home Depot, get a regular pair of pliers. So, like, if the fish has something in its mouth that's really deep and you can't grab it with your hands, or if you just don't want to touch the fish's mouth, pull out the old pliers and get it out. These ones have wire cutters on them. You don't need these because these are the same exact thing. These aren't wire cutters. Sorry, I didn't mean to say that. They're line cutters. But you don't need that. And yeah. And if you're starting to fish, you don't need a lot of tackle. You don't need expensive rods. You don't need a lot of that stuff. If you want to be a good fisherman, you don't need a lot of this stuff that a lot of people have. Some people have, like, if you watch, like, professional bass fishermen, they have boats full of stuff. They don't need all that. I guarantee you they haven't used half that stuff. This stuff, I don't even use all this. I use the same thing every time. I use a white chartreuse chatterbait, and I use peanut butter jelly football jig, and I use Texas rig random soft plastics, and I use most of these hard baits, but yeah. I don't use a lot of my stuff. And I have more stuff that I don't use. I still have my first rod from when I was little, and I still use it for bluegills. So that tells you that you really don't need a lot of stuff. To make you good, you don't need a lot of stuff. Okay? Like, this is... like, I have a room full of fish and stuff, and I don't use half of it. That's a big mistake I've made. Is spending all that money for fish and stuff. I mean, I don't regret it. I love fishing. Like, don't want people to tell you not to fish, because whatever you want to do, you can let your dreams become true. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise, but I did spend a lot of money on fish and stuff, and I don't regret it, because I use it, and one day I'll pass it on to someone else, and hopefully they'll pass it down if it's still good. So, yeah. Alright, guys. Thank you for watching and enjoy this sweet outro. Peace.
And I wonder if you know what it means, what it means. And I wonder if you know